Democratic Party Chair Luzine Bacha met with citizens and businesses in Pascuchan while proclaiming that the government has put the country into a depression. 80% of properties in Albania are reportedly registered inaccurately, while the head of Eluizni, Artan Lame, said that he will launch a full verification of files. Albanian women are ranked as having the largest representation in the workforce in the region, according to a recent report by the International Labour Organization. Good evening. It's 6 o'clock on Saturday, the 9th of March, 2019. Welcome to the English edition of Aura News. My name is Oliver, and I'm here to bring you the day's top stories from across the country, translated into English. On the second day of his visit, Prime Minister Edi Rama was met by protesters of opposition supporters. At the meeting called Municipality We Want, Rama criticized the participants of the protest, claiming that their goal is to block the country's development progress. After a reconfirmation of Arion Valiai to the head of the municipality of Tirana, Rama confirmed the name of Armando Subashi for a second term at the head of Fier's municipality. While on the 23rd of March, the Congress of the Socialist Party is expected to make other names of socialist candidates public. Referring to the public statements made by the head of the government, the name Armando Subashi puts the number of candidates vying for office at 4, against whom members of the Socialist Party will compete in local elections. Apart from Valiai, Rama has also reconfirmed the name of Sotirach Filo in Korch, whereas in Elbasan, the Socialist Party seems to have decided to run with another name after the three mandates carried out by Chazim Sedini. Meanwhile, there is still no confirmation regarding the running of Vanjush Dako in Durres. On February 16th, Rama expressed his support for the continuation of duty for Dritan Leli in Vlor, while there is still no decision for the municipality of Girokastër. A few days ago, Rama said that the Socialist Party's aim is to win all the municipalities from north to south in the June 30th elections. In front of the building in Fier where Rama was celebrating the March 8th event, Democrats held a rally against the Prime Minister. The visit by Rama in Fier was preceded by a rally in Roskovets, organized by Democratic Party supporters where vehicle tires were burned alongside the road. Regarding the withdrawal of mandates, Rama emphasized that the opposition is approaching an impasse. Rama stated that the majority remains open to dialogue, but the four-year mandate for governing is not up for negotiation. Today, Democratic Party Chair Luzine Bacha paid a brief visit to the village of Pascuchan, where he invited citizens to participate in the 16th of March protest for the removal of Prime Minister Rama's government. Bacha said the Prime Minister has chosen to impoverish and persecute Albanians and to rule the country rather than govern it. During his visit, Bacha met with several business owners in the area, promising tax cuts while stressing that when he comes to power, he plans to abolish the nation's tax toll, stating, "We will establish a government with low taxes, which provide employment opportunities for all Albanians. We have a plan for honoring this promise. We will cut the price of oil down by 30 lek, and we will reduce the small business tax to 0.5% turnover per year, excluding other taxes, local and central. We also plan on eliminating the nation's tax road toll." Meanwhile, chairwoman of the Socialist Movement for Integration Party, Monica Kyriamadi, said one of the reasons for the withdrawal of opposition mandates was to avoid civil clashes. Kyriamadi invited citizens out to protest, stressing that under the current government, citizens will end up in poverty, ultimately leading to an Albanian exodus. Meanwhile, Bacha has levied even more attacks against the current government, claiming that it must be removed due to its criminal connections. This coming Monday, the Central Election Commission plans to replace 6 opposition MPs, of which 3 come from the Democratic Party list. In Berat, Astir Viliai will be replaced by Lefter Malici. In Korcha, Clevis Baliu will be replaced by Ligarach Caramelo, while the mandate of Gent Strazizimiri will be taken over by Malinda Halilai, who is ranked number 47 on the Democratic Party's list for Tirana. According to the report released by the Central Election Commission on March 1st, Halilai has submitted her resignation to accept her mandate while also submitting her decriminalization form. regarding the mandate of former SMI MP Victor Tushai. In Lej, he will be replaced by Alda Hoti, who, despite submitting her resignation, has also presented the decriminalization form. In Duras, Nora Male's mandate is taken over by Elira Husseini, while in Girocastra, the place of Vangel Tava will be held by Adeola Braha. After the substitution of opposition MPs, it is completed the Central Election Commission on Monday. The Assembly expects to have 92 deputies in total. In the next meeting, the Central Election Commission will register 4 political parties as participants in the June 30th local elections, namely the National Unity Party, the Moderate Socialist Party, the Albanian Immigration Party, and the Albanian Conservative National Party. Although the residents of the new Ring Road project have been promised that their dwellings, which are partially affected by the project, would not be demolished, many of the owners remain fearful that their dwellings will in fact be demolished due to the change of respective ministers. One resident stated, "We have information that all our dwellings will be demolished. However, we will continue again with our protests." Residents complain that behind this decision are hidden interests, while at the same time accusing the Minister of Energy and Infrastructure of not being interested in the challenges they face as residents. Currently, the decision on the new Ring Road project does not include the demolition of these dwellings, as official states says that the project only affects a small percentage of those property owners, while the engineers of the project themselves claim that there is no risk posed to citizens of the area. The cadastre law has been approved by the President of the Republic, Ilir Meta. It was announced by the head of the Agency for Legalization, Urbanization, and Integration of Informal Areas and Buildings, Artan Lame. Lame stated that this law was improved in accordance with the President's suggestions and added that Albania has now established a legal basis for its current institution. Lame went on to say that 80% of registered assets in Albania encounter problems due to the stagnant process over the past 30 years, stating, "The president quietly approved the law on cadastre as the law aims at avoiding governmental bureaucracy. The decision to consolidate Aluizni and Mortgage into a single institution came following a 30-year delay in providing a solution to address the problems surrounding properties in Albania." He stated 80% of properties in Albania are registered inaccurately. Since 1994, the Albanian state has spent an equivalent of $200 million in the registration process alone. The government will take on all the responsibilities concerning this situation. There will be amnesty for a number of these unpaid bills over the years, but the new law will not be the one without its fair share of contention in the upcoming days. However, there is no other solution. The new law on cadastre enters into effect on March 22nd. Throughout the Balkans region, Albanian women have the highest percentage of participation in the labor force. The Our World in Data portal, which refers to the data gathered from the International Labor Organization, shows that the participation of women in the workforce in Albania stands at 47.22%, even outranking Serbia, which has 45.85% of women participating in their labor force. The percentage is even lower in Macedonia and Montenegro, where according to published data, the percentage of women participating in the workforce is 42.46% and 42.15% respectively. The country of Bosnia and Herzegovina is ranked in last place for the Balkans region, with 35.16% of women participating in the workforce. However, Albanian women themselves think differently from the results of the data that the report presents. In Europe, there are 3 countries where the participation of women in the workforce is under 40%. Those being Italy, Bosnia and Herzegovina, and lastly, Moldova. And that's the news across the country today. Thank you for watching our English edition this evening, and be sure to join me again every Monday to Saturday at 6 p.m. for the latest news from Albania. Once again, on behalf of Aura News, thank you and have a great weekend.